and Master of Ceremonies, fellow Toastmasters, ladies and gentlemen. For those of you in the house tonight who are great movie listeners or watchers, the title might seem like the title of a movie, which of course it is, but tonight I'll disappoint you. I will not be acting, even though Marlene has put up quite a scene on our behalf. There's a saying in Shona, Kuti kwete kuvonga uroi, which means to give thanks, to not give thanks, is witchcraft. Even though that may somewhat be harsh and definitely over the top, I do believe that these deeply traditional people have given me something to remember from a generation that has completely lost it. You see, this kind gesture is something that is to my generation but a dead letter. It is in these friendly gestures that one gets to extend a hand of fellowship, in these friendly gestures that one gets to understand how to relate to people, how to convey their message, and how to win the hearts of many people. I do believe in the saying that I once heard that meant nothing at the time, but currently means everything. That the words we speak become the house we live in. It took me back to a time when my grandmother moved in with us. We may be best friends now, but at the time, I absolutely hated her. I hated every single moment of her staying with us. But little did I know that the words we speak would truly become the house we lived in. She never shouted at me for any odd reason. She never beat me up. She had this calm and gentle voice every time she spoke to me or even reprimanded me. I remember how I was a kid and I used to want my way. I used to want to play, kick my ball, ride my bike outside till the street lights went on and it was dark outside. But she ended all of that. I remember how, for those who know me, as a youngster, I used to pick up big words to seem smart. And I heard the word indigestion in an advert one point. And when school got hard and I decided that I was lazy, I'd say I had indigestion and not want to go to school. She ended all of that. I remember how I then grew into a teenager, started adopting teenage ways, and became a nuisance until she ended all of that. And then I remember how those actions culminated to a point where I was borderline delinquent. And she calmly mitigated that situation. It fast-tracked me a couple of years later, how people look at me today and say, you speak such kind words. You're so well-mannered. You're so well-behaved. And I sat my grand down because now we're best friends. And I had to ask her, if I was so bad, why did I turn out like this? Was it so bad? How did we end up in the situation? And she said, are you referring to the situation where you were a kid and you wanted to get your way? Or the more you were a nag and then eventually started picking up words like indigestion and wanted to get your way? Or are you referring to the time when you became quite a nuisance in the house? Or when you completely lost your way and became a delinquent? I slowly realized that these words were true to their cause. Because I took that K from when I was a kid. I took that I from when I lied and I said I had indigestion. I took that N from when I became a nuisance. And I took that D from when I became a delinquent. And realized that it's not how I reacted, but it's how they treated me and how they spoke to me with kindness. And I realized that throughout the ages, it had become contagious and had molded me into the person that I have become. You see, the title of the speech is how I envision and how I encompass how the little things, seemingly insignificant, can mean the most to someone else's life. I remember reading the book by Raymond Ackerman, Spat to Catch a Mackerel, Key Principles to Build Your Business. He says there, no matter how good your idea, no matter how sophisticated your equipment, no matter how great your premises, a business is only as good as its people. And that began to muddle over my mind, and I realized that today, it is so true to everyone in this room.
No matter how many meetings our Goa Toastmasters may have, no matter how many people it may have or comprise of, no matter how great the environment it may create and the premises in which it holds those meetings, it is not as good as these people here today. I, for one, have had the first-hand experience of dealing with each and every member, or rather a large number of you guys. And I've seen the warmth, the energy, the ethos, the spirit, and the culture that exists within a Goa Toastmasters in every spirited occasion. And I can safely say that in respect of anything, nothing is as good as these people in this room. From the presidents that welcome us, from the members that have had 20 odd years, from the new members. And I realize that as you guys celebrate your another successful installation dinner, you will come to realize that new members will become inspired. And I hope that the same energy, the same ethos, and the same warmth that I felt and that I continue to feel will be felt by new members, and we were reinvigorated to all members. I remember once also hearing, as the sweet singer goes, Judith Sipume says, celebrating life is real, but not without a cry. Celebrating life is good, but not without a smile. Celebrating life is sweet, but not without a dance. And so I hope that you celebrate life together with everything it brings. The things you do may seem expedient at times, but everything that you do might be the greatest to someone else. Madam Master of Ceremonies.